Hello everyone, this is Dr. Vijay. Today we are going to study an important isoenzyme, creatine kinase. The enzyme commission number or enzyme code number for creatine kinase is EC2732. That means this enzyme belongs to class 2 enzyme, that is transferases. This creatine kinase, the standard abbreviation for creatine kinase is CK. So previously it is also known as CPK. It has got other name, creatine phosphokinase. This enzyme catalyzes conversion of creatine to creatine phosphate or creatine phosphate back to creatine. So this enzyme catalyzes reversible conversion of creatine to creatine phosphate, and it utilizes ATP, and ATP is converted to ADP, and the inorganic phosphate hand over to creatine, and creatine becomes creatine phosphate, a high energy compound, where this high energy phosphate will be utilized for the formation of ATP, back to ATP during muscle contraction. So this reversible reaction catalyzed by enzyme creatine kinase. This is an isoenzyme. This enzyme activity is highest in skeletal muscles, heart and brain. Apart from this, this creatine kinase is also present in other tissues in smaller quantities like GI tract, kidney, lungs and other tissues. This creatine kinase enzyme is a dimer. That means it is made up of two polypeptide chains, or we can call it as it has got two subunits, and one type of polypeptide chain is called M type. Why they have name M? Because it is mainly predominant in muscles. Another type of subunit or polypeptide chain is called B type. So they have named B type because it is predominant in the brain. Both these polypeptide chains have their gene in, for example, M type, it is present in the chromosome 14, whereas B type is present in the chromosome 19. And these two subunits, because creatine kinase is a dimer, these two subunits make a different permutation and combination and to make three types of isoenzymes. Suppose an isoenzyme of creatine kinase consists of two polypeptide chains which are B type, then we call it as CKBB. So it is a dimer, here two polypeptide chains and both are same B type, and then we call it as CK1 or CKBB. This isoenzyme of creatine kinase is predominant in brain. Not only brain, it is also present in smaller quantity in prostate gland, lungs, GI tract and kidney. And one M type of subunit or polypeptide chain combines with another B type of polypeptide. Again, this is a dimer. Now, this isoenzyme of creatine kinase is called CKMB, an important isoenzyme of creatine kinase for the diagnosis of myocardial infarction, which is predominant in the heart, CKMB. So this isoenzyme of creatine kinase is called CK2. Suppose two M subunits combine to form a dimer, such creatine kinase is called CKMM and it is predominant in skeletal muscles. So this isoenzyme is called CK3. So we have three isoenzymes, CK1, CK2, CK3. Or in other words, CKBB, CKMB, CKMM. Now why they have named CK1, CK2, CK3? This is based on their separation on an electrophoretic field. For electrophoresis, we cover this slide with the medium agar or agarose gel. Then we apply sample somewhere here. We are applying serum here. This is the serum sample on an agarose support medium. Then we connect these to the electrodes. This is anode, this is cathode, through a buffer system with a specific pH, especially for this CK isoenzyme electrophoresis. Since these enzymes are protein, they are made up of amino acids. And we know that these amino acids are always charged. So when you apply electricity, there is a medium here, agarose gel medium. So these charged isoenzymes, because each isoenzyme is different in its composition and amino acid sequence, they will migrate according to their size, charge and shape. So if you connect to this with the two electrodes with the help of buffer at a specific pH, then they will start migrate. Now we have three different band here. The band which is fastest or towards anode, it is CK1, which is BB type. Another band which follows CK1 is CK2 or CKMB. And the CK3 or CKMM, which is slowest moving. So these three are isoenzymes of creatine kinase, and we can separate by electrophoresis. Among these three isoenzymes, CK3 or CKMM is highest concentration. About 80% of creatine kinase isoenzyme is CK3, whereas about 5% is CKMB and about 1% is CK1. So the CKBB is the smallest quantity among all the CK isoenzymes. So what are the reference range for creatine kinase? So when you say total creatine kinase, that means it includes all the three isoenzymes. And again, if you see different test book, they have a different reference range. And all are correct, because this reference range depends upon the method we are following for the estimation. It might change to laboratory to laboratory depending upon the method. So the total CK in male is always high. It is about 46 to 171 units per liter. Whereas in female, it is adult female, it is about 34 to 145 units per liter. Again, this creatine kinase enzyme level depends upon age, muscle mass, physical activity. So adult male contains more of total creatine kinase. And more important to diagnose myocardial infarction is CK2 or CKMB, which is usually less than 5% of total CK, about 3 to 5% of total CK. So they say it should be less than 25 international units per liter. What are the clinical significance of creatine kinase? So this creatine kinase elevated or increased level of creatine kinase seen in all type of muscular dystrophy, whether it is a Duchenne muscular dystrophy, X-linked muscular dystrophy. So in all these conditions, there is enormous amount of creatine kinase. 80% of creatine kinase isoenzyme is CK3 or CKMM. So any muscle injury or muscular dystrophy, there is gross amount of total CK in the blood or serum. And creatine kinase, the total creatine kinase elevated in any crush injury, muscle injury or rhabdomyolysis, or even in intramuscular injection during labor or any physical exercise or in sportsmen this CK level is elevated. So in this type, the isoenzyme is CKMM. And a diagnostic enzymatic cardiac marker is CKMB. So in the myocardial infarction, CKMB elevation is a diagnostic along with some other cardiac markers. Even about 60% of patients who suffer from hypothyroidism, they have elevated total CK, and this elevation is might be due to elevation of CKMM, elevated CKMM in hypothyroidism patients. So these are the clinical significance. It is grossly elevated in muscle injury or rupture of the muscle or muscle trauma or muscular dystrophy. But the CKMB is a diagnostic enzymatic cardiac marker in case of myocardial infarction. And about 50 to 60% of hypothyroidism patient, we can also see there is elevation of CKMM. In case of myocardial infarction, so this is a very good cardiac marker among all the enzymatic cardiac markers. You can see in the x-axis, I have plotted every 5 hours. This is a time in hours. And y-axis, the level of CKMB or CK2. So immediately after myocardial infarction, we can see there is elevation of or raise in the CKMB level. The raise starts between 3 to 6 hours after myocardial infarction. So this is one of the earliest enzymatic cardiac marker. So this elevation starts after 3 to 6 hours of MI. And the peak level reaches between 18 to 24 hours. The level will become maximum within 18 to 24 hours. And this level will come back to normal between 2 to 3 days. So this is a very good diagnostic enzymatic cardiac marker. So this is with respect to creatine kinase, which is a diagnostic enzyme for diagnosis of myocardial infarction, that is CKMB or CK2. It is a dimer made up of two type of polypeptide chains or subunits. One is M type, another one is B type. Thanks for watching.